Welcome to the Word of Faith happening at PBC Northgate, Avira Ruaka. We are glad that you are tuned in. The entrance of God's Word brings light. May your life not be in darkness, but be in the light of God. Walking in the light of God is a song we used to sing. I'm reading scripture from Judges chapter 16, the story of Samson and Delilah. Bible says, sometimes later, Samson fell in love with a woman in the valley of Soleil. Her name was Delilah. The rulers of the Philistines went to her and said, see if you can lure him in showing you the secret of his great strength and how we can overpower him so we may tie him up and subdue him. Each one of us will give you 1,100 shekels of silver. Delilah saw that Samson had told her everything. She sent word to the rulers of the Philistines. Come back once more. He told me everything. So the rulers of the Philistines returned with the money in their hands. Having put him to sleep on her lap, she called a man to shave off the 7 braids of his hair and so began to subdue him, and his strength left him. Then she called, Samson, the Philistines are upon you. He awoke from his sleep and thought, I'll go out as before and shake myself free. But he did not know that the Lord had left him. Ichabod. Then the Philistines seized him, gouged out his eyes, took him down to Gaza, beat him with bronze shackles, set him to grind in the prison. Meanwhile, the hair on his head began to grow again after it had been shaved. The story of Samson and Delilah is a classic and is famous all over the world. Music about Delilah, novels about her, because a very poignant story. Samson knew or thought that he was in love. And he testified about how much he loved the writer. I don't know that the writers are still there in our time. I believe they are. I don't know what's going to happen to our young men if they're not able to discern what's happening. Because this lady had a price tag. The Bible says that the Philistines told her, if you can tell us the secret of his strength, each one of us will give you 1,100 shekels of silver. It's good to reevaluate your relationships and check what is the driver of your love. Is it the money from the Philistines? Is it gain? If you have a friend, if they don't pay rent and buy food, do you kick them out? I don't know. It's very interesting looking at Delilah and Samson. Samson was a man anointed of God. He was a Nazirite, set apart. No wine, no fermented drink. His hair never cut because he was dedicated to God. But even dedicated men, they fail. And Samson failed. The Bible says that when he told Delilah the secret of his strength, she called back the Philistines and said, come once more, bring me the money. And then she told them the secret. And he was shaved and he had no more strength. And Samson had a terrible ending because they took out his eyes. Then they bound him in chains and they used him like an animal, like a donkey. They used him to grind. They put him to grind in the prison. They ground their wheat, their corn in the prison. A prisoner working in the prison. Very sad, very sad. The story of an anointed man felled by a derider. There are other women mentioned in scripture, like Jezebel, also music about her is there, abounding, also very evil. And it's my prayer that God will help us to have a spirit of discernment, especially for young people, because look, you have your whole future before you, you have a career before you, and it's just a question of a decision. That in that moment of decision, you'll have a sober mind. There's no record here that Samson prayed. He never asked God what he should do. He never asked God whether this Delilah was a genuine woman. In fact, she was a Canaanite woman. She didn't have the fear of God in her upbringing. So be very careful when you make choices, especially if you want to serve God, and especially if the anointing of God is upon you. We don't want you to end up like Samson did, because there are many out there whose love comes only at a price. And they're not able to outstand. They're not able to live long enough beyond the human capacity. But if you trust God, then you'll experience a love who which is genuine, a love which is deep, a love which is for all seasons, a love that will never fail. May God help you to have this spirit of discernment. Father, we thank you because so many young people today, they are in this valley of decision. They find beautiful women or handsome young men, but the spirit of discernment. May God help you so that at every point that you need to take a decision, go down on your knees, ask God to lead you and to guide you. He will never misdirect you. The Bible says you'll hear a voice behind you saying, this is the way, walk ye in it. I speak defeat to every derider. I speak defeat to every Jezebel spirit so that there may be hope for young people and so that they may firm up and become productive in their lives and bear God much fruit. This is to our Father's glory that you bear much fruit and show yourselves to be his disciples. God bless you for tuning in, and we hope and pray that you'll continue meditating on the Word of God. When you meditate on the Word of God day and night, you'll be prosperous, you'll be successful. God bless you.